Hello friends, this is Sanaur Rahman. In this video, I am going to show you how to perform data logging operation in the Delta DOP-B series HMI and save the data samples in the USB whenever needed. The specialty of this HMI is its large non-volatile memory for recording historical data. It can record temperature data from two sensors for 1 year, keeping sampling time to 1 minute. The hardware used for this purpose is Delta DOP-B series HMI, Delta DVP ES2 series PLC, Delta DVP04PTE2 temperature measurement module, power supply 24V DC, communication cables, and temperature probe PT100. The software used to program the HMI and PLC is DOP Soft version 2.00.07, and for PLC programming, WPL Soft version 2.45. Before starting this video, it is requested from you to please subscribe my channel. This is necessary to maintain the operation of the channel. Now let's start from the programming of the PLC. Open WPL Soft. Create new file. Enter the program title. Select PLC model as ES2. Input an instruction. Load moment contact and 1000. Divide the channel 1 value by 10. Channel 1 value is available in register D9900 and saved in register D10. As I am using 2 PT100, so there are 2 values present. Second value is shown in register D9901. Divide this also by 10 and save in register D11. Now save the project and close. Now open the DOP Soft to program the HMI. Create new file. Here I am using B07S411. Assign the project name. Use link 1, COM1 if you have only one PLC and one HMI. Now go to option and then history buffer setup. Thank you. add buffer properties, assign the address as D9900. Set the data length to, here I am setting 4, and set the sample number 43200. This is calculated on monthly basis. In 1 month there are 43,200 minutes, and set the sample cycle 6000 milliseconds. This is 60 seconds or 1 minute. Check the stamp date and time. Check non-volatile memory. Check export CSV file. And then click OK. Now go to element. Go to element, sampling and historical data table. Set border color and background color. And enable the vertical line and horizontal line. Set data field number as 2. In details of historical data table, set start position as 0 and 1. This is because you have select only one data D9900, and if there are both values start position is 0, then it will show only D9900. Set the title as RTD1 and RTD2. In this way, two values can be read, D9900 and D9901. Check show title, time format, date. Date and time take 6 bytes of data. So it's up to you if you need to include or not. Now go to element button, report list. This button is necessary to move all historical data from non-volatile memory to USB. Report device is USB. Enter the text as saved data. Through this button, you can download all your data in your USB. Now to remove USB, go to element button and remove storage. Check access type as USB disk. Write down the text. Through this button you can safely remove your USB. Now to display the values of the tooth sensor, display the numeric values. Go to element display and numeric display. Enter D9900 in the read address. Select the border color and background color of your choice and select the font size. Integer digit is 2 and fraction is 1, means 2 digit shown before the decimal and 1 after the decimal. Now just copy this display. And change its read address as 9901. Here the values from the two RTD sensors can easily be seen through numeric display. Now save the project and close. Here the screen shows the values of the RTD 1 and RTD 2 as well as the historical data table. You can see that every 6 seconds the historical data table takes the sample. Now plug the USB in the HMI, save the data in the USB. Now remove the USB safely. Here you can see the file saved in the USB. The HMI generates this CSV file and here are the two RTD values, RTD 1 and RTD 2. These two values are without decimals, so you need to first divide these values by 10. This is the only reason I divide the value in the PLC and save in the register D10 and D11. So it's up to you, whatever you want. Thank you for watching this video. If you find this video as informative, then please subscribe my channel and like my MED videos. This is necessary to maintain the operation of the channel. Thank you.